Hello and welcome. What I have for you today is a no-brand Intel 760 chipset ITX motherboard. I googled the letters and numbers on this sticker here to find the exact model name, but it came up with absolutely nothing, so I have no clue what the brand is. Anyway, this motherboard costs $64 and is 760 chipset, making it a pretty good deal. Your alternative choice would be Jginyue 610 motherboard. This one has a better chipset. How does that translate to reality for ITX motherboard is generally more USB ports in the back and more PCI Express lanes for M.2 slots. There is very little information on this board. What I do know for certain is that it supports DDR4 and has two M.2 slots. And the PCI Express for GPU is version 4 with full 16 lanes. I don't know how the M.2 slots are wired, however. Normally Chinese ITX motherboards seem to have 4 lanes and 2 lanes, but this is based on 760 chipset and should do better. These two boards are very similar. 760 is a better chipset on paper, but it's down to motherboard manufacturers to implement more advanced features. And, from my own experience, Jginyue 610 chipset is feature-packed and is nothing to scoff at. In the end, I believe that you get what you pay for, meaning that both motherboards are probably virtually identical in its features, in spite of the no-brand motherboard having a better chipset. Still, the no-brand motherboard does seem to have slightly better spec. It does have two more MOSFETs, and has better USB ports in the back. It's time to dive into its BIOS and see what it offers. Actually, before I did that, I unscrewed the Wi-Fi box to see whether they had a Wi-Fi card installed. It turns out that it's an empty box. Jginyue 610 did have a Wi-Fi card installed. This does add to overall cost. Anyway, the CPU is Intel 13600T with a pair of DDR4 16GB sticks. The BIOS date is not old, but not recent enough either. Alder Lake Core is fine, but Raptor Lake Core is a big nope on this motherboard. What that means is any 13th and 14th gen with a K at the end of its model name, or anything that supports DDR5600. Okay, here is power limit settings for the CPU. Again, it looks like the default setting is just outright ignore any power limits, which seems to be a common trend among Chinese motherboards. The limit is there for a reason, so I am going to put a reasonable value here, like 65 watts. Meanwhile, I didn't find any settings for RGB control, which means the RGB header is there for no apparent reason. Weird. Alright, I've booted into Unix Mint and... The CPU clock is too low. Something is off here. Let me stress the CPU and see whether it goes up. It shouldn't be this low unless it's idling. Something is definitely wrong here, and I am thinking it's the power limit value I put in. I am going to go back into the BIOS and see what's going on. Okay. Perhaps I should have read what's written on the right. It looks like I need to add 3 zeros. For example, if I want a 65 watts limit, I have to input 65,000. You know what? I will just put 125,000 and see how it goes. Yep, this is how it should be. It is hitting 4 GHz with 125 watts power limit. So far, this motherboard is proving to be all right. In addition, I have a surprise for you. I had to check what speed the two M.2 slots run at, so I booted up Windows and fired up Crystal Disk Info. I was fully expecting PCI Express Generation 3 speed. However, to my surprise, the primary M.2 slot was running at Gen 4 and 4 lanes. Since the second M.2 drive was Gen 3, I had to switch my Gen 4 M.2 drive to the back to see whether it runs at Gen 4 as well. To my surprise, the back M.2 slot was running at Gen 4 and 4 lanes as well, meaning this motherboard features two Gen 4 M.2 slots at 4 lanes. This alone makes this motherboard far superior to Jginyue 610 ITX motherboard. In conclusion, I feel that this motherboard hits several jackpots. The fact that it has two Gen 4 M.2 slots is a very pleasant surprise. It also utilizes cheaper DDR4, which you may already have. Sadly, the rather outdated BIOS limits your choice of CPU to Alder Lake cores. Since I have no idea where to download newer BIOS for this motherboard, updating it is out of the question. In fact, the BIOS didn't have any updating feature at all, as if updating it isn't even an option. Having said that, its price cannot be beaten. I mean, it's just $64. Try to find an ITX motherboard with a similar feature set from known brands. It's going to set you at least twice more. Your alternative option from a similar price point is Jginyue 610 motherboard. But you lose out heavily on M.2 slot speeds, which run at Gen 3 4 lanes and 2 lanes. It does feature fully patched BIOS version, which allows safe operation for Raptor Lake CPUs, however. So you win some and lose some. Finally, this motherboard is found at Alibaba rather than AliExpress. The latter tends to carry only popular items. The former carries a lot of experimental stuff, and this is one of them, I believe. It took some efforts to get the seller to ship it to Canada because he didn't want to bother to ship just one piece. I am hoping to find more of these products and show them to you in near future. I thank you for watching and see you next time.